sports. It's in the game.
Big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in a slot, trying to bend the corner of your limbs. Getting that's your partner, then your twin game. All you wanna do is talk, I don't need talk.
I don't hear somebody talk.
I can pull up with that, Chewbacca.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League brings us to Western Pennsylvania and Heinz Field in the Steel City of Pittsburgh. This was the scene just a few moments ago as the Pittsburgh faithful were fired up by the hometown Steelers taking the field. They're all set as they'll match up with the Cleveland Browns. Here we go from Heinz Field as Chris Boswell tees it up and boots it away. From his end zone, it's Demetric Felton. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Throwing, Mayfield. And his throw is incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Here's a quick throw to Higgins out wide. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and seven ahead. Mayfield off the play fake. And it's hauled in by Austin Hooper. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. Mayfield finding Hooper there for a Cleveland first. Mayfield. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
That's an excellent play by the defender. He diagnosed that one, closed quickly, and helped force the incompletion.
5 yards. Now it's third and five. Play action now. Here's Mayfield. It's caught by OBJ. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. The Browns passing game finding its stride. They've got another first down. Mayfield hands it off to Chubb. He takes it down to the 42, a 5-yard run.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to have 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
Mayfield's throw taken in by Landry. Mayfield on target to Landry for a Browns first down. And the pocket's been protected pretty good here so far in the opening drive.
We always talk about confidence in runners and catchers and quarterbacks. How about the protection detail? They're not allowing anyone near the guy throwing the football.
And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Now they return to the ground game. Chubb takes this to the 32, maybe the 31, and then the defense rallying quickly after that broken tackle. 5 yards, now it's third and five. Here's Mayfield. Steps away to his left. And he will go down outside of the pocket for a sack. Tried to get away, but could not. Chris Wormley drops him for a 4-yard loss there, and that brings up fourth down. They go play action. Mayfield flush to his right. To the sideline, and he's got it. They say the feet are down. Yes, the line judge says they're in. That'll be a first down. They'll get 19 yards there. And it's good enough for a Cleveland first down. Mayfield knocks this forward. It's a jet sweep. We're scoreless after one. The start of the second quarter, and it's the Browns in control of the football as they've got it with second down and less than a yard. Play fake, Mayfield. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Down near the goal line, things really get physical. You're always anticipating a running play, but when they do throw it, things happen quickly. A little bit of a bang-bang play there that falls incomplete.
The offense on third down tonight, they've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. They're looking at third in the nose of the football. They'll throw again. Here's Mayfield. And he is going to go down. Back at the 11-yard line. Chris Wormley. Able to drop him that time for his second sack of the evening. And his kick is indeed good. And the Browns are out to a 3-0 lead. So a nice drive on the road. You come in, you take the ball down, you get 3 points.
Yeah, points are a must on an opening drive, right? So they moved it down efficiently, got it done. I think that bodes well for their chances moving forward in this one.
The football will come out to the 25 as McLeod will not return it. Big Ben and the Steelers with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. A handoff to Harris to begin the drive. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game. Trying to establish the inside run. Run with toughness now. Hopefully get to the perimeter later. And let's face it, you could do worse than a four-yard run on first down.
From the 29, Roethlisberger. It's brought in by Harris. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. It'll be a gain of 17 and a Pittsburgh first. Now a first down carry for Harris. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. Now Roethlisberger. And they get to him with a pressure as Roethlisberger goes down. The number one pick, Myles Garrett, coming in to drop him.
But found his way into the backfield, and he simply would not be denied.
Well, they say that life's all about opportunities, and that holds true when you're playing defense as well. How about him seeing that chance, making the most of it, did a great job of wrapping him up and bringing him down.
Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect. On fourth down, here's Presley Harvin on to punt. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And the Browns will take over with a first and 10 deep in their own territory. The Browns drive about to get started. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Looking to throw again on second down. Mayfield. And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down. Mayfield now. He'll rifle this one deep right side, and that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down.
Well, I think that was good strategy there, trying to go right back to him after the last completion. But this time, the defense was all over it, and they got there to break that one up.
And his throw here is incomplete.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because they didn't completions on first and second down. Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. If you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
Mayfield on play action. He'll let it go deep for Beckham. And a high throw there as this is knocked away down to the ground and incomplete.
So one first down on that drive and that's it. Forced to take the deep shot on third down and couldn't hit it. Now they have to punt this one away.
The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth. And they're indeed going. It's Mayfield. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Boy, a real head-scratcher there. And that will force a turnover on downs.
I'm coming.
They'll run on first down. Harris. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Now it's Roethlisberger. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. Now the Steelers use the first of their three timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. So it's first and goal and a great opportunity to get that lead back before the break. On the give, this is Harris, and he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. The Steelers signal for the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal. Let's go, D-tighten up. 56 a mile. Here's Roethlisberger. Open man is Johnson. Touchdown, Steelers. The 3-yard touchdown pass, and the Steelers have taken the lead. Now Mike Tomlin says, let's go ahead and go for 2. That could be an important swing right there, a touchdown in the final minute of the half to take the lead.
And I like the point you just made there. Could be an important swing because now that they have the lead, if they can carry that into the locker room at the half, they'll feel...
And oh, it'll be intercepted. Snags it for the pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Well, now to kick it away after the touchdown. From his end zone, it's Demetric Felton. And not a good return here at all as they'll be forced to start at the 12-yard line. Drive about to get started, and they really won't have much time to work with, just 19 seconds showing on the clock. Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete.
But no kneeling for them. They decided they weren't going to run out the clock. They decided to take their shot downfield, hoping to either make a connection or a pass interference call. They wanted more points to put on the board.
Throwing again, Mayfield on second and 10. Eluding the pressure right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. So the big play moves him all the way across midfield. It's first and 10 from the 45. Now Mayfield. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
I like the thought process there. They connected on a big play, and sometimes you find the defense vulnerable. So they went for the bigger shot, went for it all on that one. This time, they were ready for it.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Final play of the half, Mayfield. He's going to take a shot at the end zone. Why not? And that will be incomplete. Try to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. So time for the second half as the Steelers have the lead, and they will also be receiving the football here to start the third quarter. Returning from his end zone is Ray McLeod. Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. They go play action with Roethlisberger. And this one is incomplete.
This has certainly been a physical game so far. Limited scoring opportunities for both sides. And there's another chance that goes unfulfilled.
A good action to this point in the third quarter. Just a three-point game. Second and 10. A run with Harris out of the shotgun. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gun.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
And this is going to be a Steelers first down as he'll take this up to the 38-yard line.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. So it goes as a completed pass, but they lose a full 5 yards. Behind the sticks here with a second and 15. Here's Roethlisberger to throw. Man open, that's Ray McCloud. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down. Roethlisberger's throw hauled in by Washington. That catch good for only a couple. Second and 8 coming up. Now it's Roethlisberger. And he overshot in there. It's out of bounds, incomplete.
A deep ball down that right sideline, and he made sure that he put it where either his guy was going to catch it or no one was.
And the line to gain here is the 37 on third down. They hand this off to Harris. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. They'll get 6 there on the run, but it brings up fourth down. They're going on fourth down. It's Roethlisberger. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Steelers try it, but they come up empty on fourth down. And this Browns defense stands tall. They start on the ground with Nick Chubb. Chubb will have the first down and much more. He gets it across the 50 and down to the 48. First down yardage on the first play of the drive, 14 yards. Mayfield looks to throw. He'll buy some time right. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable. And that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
And he's got some space here. And all the way in, touchdown, Cleveland. Nick Chubb, 48 yards. And once again, the Browns are back in front. So it takes them just 3 plays here to find the end zone. And you remember, of course, this was all set up by their defense.
Yeah, they got the stop on fourth down. So I imagine the offense said to their defense, thank you very much for this great starting field position. And like you said, 3 plays later, they're in the end zone.
Returning from his end zone is Ray McCloud. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to looking for Johnson, and it's intercepted. picked off by Denzel Ward. They had him back deep, got the interception, and now they start inside the 10.
Partner, forget starting inside the red zone. They're inside the green zone. From the 10-yard line in, a lot of teams call it that because that's the money zone. Get it into the end zone and make your cash.
Suddenly, it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. Following the interception, Mayfield. He'll find Schwartz complete right side. And they'll get this from the 8 to the 5. Pickup of 3. On second and goal, Mayfield. And that's going to be caught for a Browns touchdown. Mayfield finding Odell Beckham with a touchdown pass. And the Browns take advantage of field position on the turnover to cash this one in. Well, this offense only mustered 3 points in the first half on that field goal. They picked up the pace now. 2 third-quarter touchdowns.
Hey, you remember that appearance we had last week in front of that crowd? And they asked about halftime adjustments and all that was going on. And remember what I said. It's not always an adjustment at halftime. Sometimes just remembering the game plan and playing better, tuning it up and just working through it methodically, they got it done in this case.
Of course, I'll always remember that appearance because I had on a brown belt with black shoes and you pointed that out in front of the crowd. So thanks for that.
I said that out loud.
You did.
My bad.
The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see when they decide to do it.
Oh, and a bad throw there. It's intercepted. Troy Hill picks it. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to unnerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one? Or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
Mayfield going to lead the Browns up now. First and 10 at their own 28-yard line. Flushed out right. And he will find his man Schwartz. That's complete. And all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. Anthony Schwartz. 72 yards, and the Browns get another third-quarter touchdown to add on to that lead. McLaughlin for the extra point. And the lead is up to 18 now. And they will not have time to get another play in here as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Returning from his end zone is Ray McLeod. The football will come out to the 25 as McLeod will not return it. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
Under four to go now as they come up on second down. Now Roethlisberger to throw. Hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Well, so far in this drive, they've done some good work. They force incompletions on first and second down, bring up third and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure or do they play coverage on this down?
The Steelers on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is third and 10 to throw here, Roethlisberger. This is Chase Claypool on the receiving end. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that's going to bring up a fourth down. Let's get back, Here we go. It's Roethlisberger on fourth down. Over the middle, that's caught by McCloud. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. No reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth. Ben's throw complete there to Johnson. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. This gain not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two. Pressure applied, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back at the 33-yard line. Myles Garrett, his second sack of the night. After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Another try after the first down sack. Roethlisberger, he'll take a shot for the end zone. And, oh, that would get a wide-up incomplete. Nearly an interception in the end zone. Probably should have been. Third down coming up. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Roethlisberger will throw. And Big Ben intercepted a third time. Picked off by Mack Wilson. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
As a quarterback, Charles, you have to imagine that he knew that heat was coming there on that snap, and this time the pressure forces him into an interception.
Absolutely he knew, and maybe that's a spot in other parts of the game. He's going to think about just throwing that one away, but down late in the fourth quarter, he has no choice, no luxury. He's got to try and make a play, and even with that pressure around him, he tried to complete it downfield to no avail.
And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. So the Browns in possession of the football here as we get your reset. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory. Chubb will have the first down and much more. And he's going to get this into enemy territory at the 45.
95 yards on the ground for him now as he's gotten better, really, as the night's gone on.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Well, the lead late in the fourth, but Mayfield's going to throw it. The 20! And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. Over 30 yards there. And first downs on three consecutive plays now. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Escaping the pressure right. And this is caught. Touchdown. Wait, hold a second here. Flag down. Let's see if this will stand. So erase the red zone score. They'll have to dial that one up again.
And you know how difficult it is to strike in the red zone because things are a little bit more condensed. You got to go back to their play chart and see if they can dial up another one.
Throw left side there, Schwartz with it. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and seven ahead. From the gun, Mayfield. Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Micah Fitzpatrick. Before we came up to the booth, last thing he said as we were walking off the field, want to play mistake-free football. Well, that just went out the window there with a pick.
And do you remember what you said to me when we were walking up to the booth after he said that? You're like, oh, fatal last words. Every time we hear that, things tend to fall apart a little bit, and that's what we saw there. Didn't get enough on that throw, and it turned into an interception.
Now the Steelers use the first of their three timeouts as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds left to go. And what is this? They're lining up here to punt on first down. And they won't get a chance to bring this one back. It goes out of bounds, back near their own 20. The Browns drive about to get started. They have the dream scenario you hope for coming into the game. Just one kneel here, and this game should be over.
And it's always the final play of preparation each week. The practicing of the kneel down formation, the victory formation.
Pressure comes, and down goes Baker Mayfield. Now the Steelers use the second of their three timeouts as they get it with 16 seconds remaining on the clock. Second and 21, a lot of ground to cover. So instead of running, Mayfield's going to throw it here. And finding the tight end, Hooper. And we've got a timeout. 9 seconds remaining. And the Steelers now in the nickel here on third down. To throw, Mayfield. And it's caught by Hooper. And he will finally be taken down, but not before he reaches the 38. And now with 4 seconds left, we get a timeout call. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Mayfield to throw it. Throw left side complete. That's Higgins. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. We're at the confluence of the Ohio, Allegheny, and Monongahela Rivers at Heinz Field in Pittsburgh, PA. They love the black and gold here in the Steel City, and a few moments ago, their Steelers emerged from the Heinz Field tunnel. They're set, we're set, as the Steelers are ready to do battle with the Buffalo Bills. Returning from his end zone is Ray McCloud. On first down, it's Roethlisberger. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down.
It's another zone defense. It looks like it's open for possibilities, but they did a nice job patrolling the middle of the field and forcing an incompletion.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. And they'll run for the first time with Najee Harris. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. The Steeler first down on the pickup of 11 yards. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front and linebackers, you're exactly right. It'll be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Now Roethlisberger. Short little throw to Ebron. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. The Steeler first down on the pickup of 11 yards.
I like how they worked the tight end on a nice little under route there. And if you're going to give him that much space, he's not even going to catch the football. He's going to run away from you a little bit. And that's exactly what he just did there, picking up extra yardage.
Couple of first downs to kick off the drive. Here's first and 10 up at the 46. Roethlisberger. He's going to look deep down the field. And this is taken in at the 5. And oh, so close as he takes it all the way to the 2-yard line. Every defensive staff harps on limiting explosive plays. Job not so well done there.
Yeah, they talk about it all the time. A lot harder to stop, though, isn't it? And when you think of an explosive play, most offensive staffs define them as passes of 20 or more yards.
And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers. Najee Harris taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Steelers take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. Boswell good with the extra point. And it's now a 7-0 game. Well, now to kick it away after the touchdown. From his end zone, Isaiah McKenzie. And this return will net positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10 at their own 27. A run on first down that won't even get back to the line of scrimmage. He will lose a yard, second and 11. On second and 11 now. Allen, he's got it complete to Stephon Diggs. 20! And all the way home for a Bills touchdown. Stephon Diggs, 74 yards. And the Bills are an extra point away from tying the football game. Extra point by Bass, up and good. And that will tie our score here in this opening quarter of play. Each team's had it, each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. Returning from his end zone is Ray McCloud. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. So now, defensively, you've almost got to get down into those starters' blocks like you're a sprinter. Get lower than those guys on offense and find a way to roar through them or around them to get into the face of the passer.
Easier said than done, though.
Way easier said than done. But they've got to try something because right now, they're just cutting them to shreds.
To throw again on second down, Roethlisberger, and he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
Trying to pick it up on the ground with Harris. And Harris is not going to get there. Great work defensively to stop him short. No gain on the play there. A nice job defensively. And it likely forces a punt situation on fourth. They're going for it. This is Harris. And boy, is he close. Did he get there? No, they're going to say he's short of the line to gain. Boy, a curious decision to go for it doesn't pan out, and it'll be a turnover on downs. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. To throw, it's Allen. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Sanders. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. The catch and run there, good for 16 and a first.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Allen gonna throw. Out to the left, he's got his tight end, Knox. Touchdown! Dawson Knox, a touchdown grab from Josh Allen. And the Bills have taken the lead.
Well, we know someone just added to his touchdown passing total, but all he did was get the ball out quickly to his tight end and let him take care of business the rest of the way.
Extra point by Bass, up and good. And that makes the score 14-7. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
How many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. On second down, this is Harris. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
On first and 10, it's Roethlisberger. They'll set up the screen to Ballage. Not much there, only a yard.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
Now it's second and 9. Here's Roethlisberger. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Picked off by Tremaine Edmonds, the linebacker. And they will set up shop at their own 46-yard line.
Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball, and I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
So after the INT, it's Allen. Allen hit. He lost the football. And fortunately, the Bills jump on it and get it back. So they keep the football, but now face second and long. Allen now looks to throw. A first down there on a pickup of 25.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
Allen now on first down. Flush to his right. Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted. Thrown back across his body. Picked up by Minkah Fitzpatrick. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Micah Hyde.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. They'll flip this quickly out to Beasley. Evades the tackler and now some space. And he's able to get this one all the way past the 30. And a nice gain of 21 yards. First down, and they're going to throw with Allen, eluding the pressure right. It's complete to Diggs. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. Another first down there as this one goes for 25.
So many times in my career I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. But as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
And he's going to have the first down as they move into field goal range here at the 25-yard line.
Would you say this offense is locked in right now?
They're having no trouble on this drive. What is it, three plays, three first downs?
Yeah, you talk about on the march. They keep this up, they'll get to that end zone real fast.
So they fake the handoff. Now Allen. Throw left side is complete on the diving effort. Now the Bills are going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. Here's Allen. Touchdown, Bills! Cole Beasley, as the first half is winding down. And the Bills would extend their lead here just before halftime.
And that's certainly an important score right there because they gave themselves a two-score cushion heading towards halftime. Now you got to force the other team out of their comfort zone, and it changes the way you approach the second half as well. How you want to do things on offense, and your defense feels much better too, having that lead.
Returning from his end zone is Ray McLeod. The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive as they go to work with 12 seconds on the clock. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Looking deep here for Ebron. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down.
Thus far, they have been able to move the line of scrimmage very well in the running game. Almost felt like they said in the huddle, can you guys pass protect? Let's take a big shot downfield. Didn't get it on that one, but they may come back to it again.
He's going to go up top again. And Big Ben intercepted a third time. Levi Wallace with a pick. And he will be brought down. His time is now run out on this first half of action. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down. Two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. And how about this line out of the locker room? An onside kick attempt. Bills with the lead, and they'll get the football first as the second half is underway. And this one travels out of bounds. So unsuccessful there on the onside kick try. And he'll run straight into a wall of tacklers at the line of scrimmage. It's second down. A second and 10 forthcoming here. Third quarter action in the Steel City of Pittsburgh, PA. Now Allen. A quick throw going to be caught by Diggs. A great job there, Charles, just to hold on, absorb that contact. I guess that's the risk you take catching the ball toward the middle of the field.
It is, and if you're going to gain yardage, you're going to have to go there at some point. But how about the read, okay? The eyes of that play. Stepping out from the middle of the field and really making a big hit. Did not get free, but boy, that's a tough area to go into when you're going into his spot.
He'll find Diggs once more on the completion. And he is going to have a Bills first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete. Here's second and 10. Now it's Allen. Oh, that'll be incomplete. Oh, he took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down. Not his best throw there, but where we sit right now in the third quarter, he's had a pretty good game throwing the football.
He certainly has, and it's not exactly at the point where we're doing four-minute offense yet, but they've got to think about, I'm not going to say milking the clock, but understanding clock management here on out.
And this will not get close to the first down marker as he's brought down at the 26. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down. To the air, Allen. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And this Steeler defense able to come up with a stop. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off around the 37. And the return stops just a few yards shy of midfield. They'll spot the ball at the 47-yard line. Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10 on their side of midfield at the 47. Here's Allen to throw it. Works right side into the hands of the tight end, Knox. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 15 yards is the pick up there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down. Allen off the play fake. And he's got his man here, Beasley. And he will reach the 8-yard line before going out. Give him 30 yards there. He had one touchdown earlier, nearly a second one there.
Yeah, it took a touchdown-saving tackle to keep him out of the end zone after a big play. Perhaps you go right back to him. Don't need the distance, but maybe he can pay things off after a big effort.
On play action, Allen. They'll roll him out right. He's got it complete to Diggs, right side. Touchdown! Allen on target there to Stephon Diggs. And the Bills turn that interception into a touchdown.
You have fun with this one, partner.
I am. He's been fun to watch under center.
We always talk about, you know, getting to the next level, right? When we see people get into the zone, this guy's in the master class right now. What a performance he's putting on, just carving him up.
Four touchdown passes, carving him up is right. Seems like everything he throws is going to be a completion and going in the end zone. Returning from his end zone is Ray McCloud. The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes.
And now here is another interception. Teron Johnson able to pick it, and he'll take this back all the way up past the 45-yard line. That is now five interceptions that he has thrown in this ball game. If I asked you to speculate what's possibly going on in his head, what would you say?
Well, if he's as mentally strong as I believe he is, he understands that not all these picks have been his fault. You know, some of the throws, yes, but there have been a good number of them where he hasn't been helped by his own receivers, and they've turned into interceptions. So he knows if he keeps firing, perhaps good things can happen, not just in this game, but especially in later ones.
As they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. To the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. On play action, Allen sliding out of the pocket. And he whips that one incomplete there. The incompletion there stops the clock. Any surprise they're throwing here late?
Ordinarily, yes, because you would think enough is enough. They've got plenty of lead, but I've seen this a bunch of times as well. The defense is going to crowd the line of scrimmage. If you just hand it off inside, you're getting your running back popped a lot as well.
Oh, Allen cannot get away, and down he goes. T.J. Watt causing the disruption. He gets the sack. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. He's got the hookup with Diggs. And all the way home for a Bills touchdown. Stephon Diggs, 46 yards. And the Bills capitalize on the fumble and turn it into six. And you wonder now if he might be able to remove the helmet, put on the baseball cap, and watch the rest of this one from the sideline. His fifth touchdown pass of the game.
Say that again. Did you say fifth touchdown pass of the game?
Yes, sir.
Boy, that's a heck of a performance, isn't it? Because they've had no answer for him at all game long. Receivers have been open constantly, and he hasn't missed a single one of them.
And he'll wind up getting a couple extra yards here for his trouble of bringing it out of the end zone as he's down at the 27. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmaker.
And my goodness, another interception. Teron Johnson able to pick it. And they will finally get to him, but a great return has set him up first and goal at the 5.
Oh, yeah.
He had his eyes on the end zone. He got close. At least he set the offense up nicely, but he's probably mad he didn't take that one to pay dirt.
I agree with you, and you know he's going to get teased because he didn't get it all the way into the end zone. But if they don't score now, if they don't get a touchdown, he won't just get teased. They'll be glaring at him. How'd you not score?
They are certainly not letting up on the pressure in this one. And oftentimes you hear this expression, all gas, no break from defenses. But in this case, it's the offense still throwing the football up big in the fourth quarter.
A line of scrimmage once again, the 5, as they get ready for second and goal. Throwing now is Allen, rolling to his right. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, lived to fight another down, right?
Allen now on third and goal. He'll buy some time right, and this will be caught. And the carnage continues. It's another touchdown. Even though they've got this big advantage, Charles, they are not taking their foot off the gas pedal right now.
Well, I think what we're seeing is the result of all their great preparation and great practice time during the week. And even though it seems like this is a great chance to pull people back and maybe, you know, not try and score a few more times, they don't want to do that. I think they're enjoying what they're seeing, the collective effort, and they want to play it all the way out.
After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. Returning from his end zone is Ray McLeod. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Cost him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. I had one tell me once, you know, we were having a tough patch. This too shall pass. This too shall pass. And finally, we kept having a rough patch. He said, but you've got to do something to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here.
Just like that. 49's the mic. Watch 49. You don't want none. Pick up the ball.
And now again, the play clock's going to run out on him. He didn't even try to signal for a timeout, so they must have not been aware of the numbers.
I think he lost track of the time left in the play clock and probably was trying to read the defense and trying to figure out which play to run and just lost track, and it cost him.
Successive penalties have them looking now at a 1st and 20. Now Roethlisberger to throw. He finds his target, Ebron. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. That'll wind up a gain of 27 on the catch and run. Now Roethlisberger on 1st down. And that is incomplete.
Another throw there off the mark, and obviously he's battled all of the interceptions. Things just haven't been true to form for him. I don't know. What do you think's going on out there, CD?
That's a great question, and my suspicion is he's been coached really well to not show that he's having a problem. You know, they always tell you, no matter what, you keep throwing the football with confidence. Well, we're not seeing a confident thrower right now. He's off balance, the passing game's off balance, and the defense is taking advantage.
And that'll fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's third down. So now third and 10. A big play to start the drive, but nothing since. Ben to throw again. This one into the hands of the running back, Melange. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. The passing game in rhythm right now for Pittsburgh. There's another first down. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Steelers with the football as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. And here's a throw right side, taken in by his tight end. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. That's a staple of this offense, drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
From the 39, Roethlisberger. And they get to him with a pressure as Roethlisberger goes down. So the sack, and now a third and long situation for the Steelers and Ben Roethlisberger. Now Roethlisberger. Looking deep here for Ebron. And now here's another interception. Picked off by Jordan Poyer. The utter domination here just continues. This defense, I don't know what more we can say all around about their performance.
Well, it certainly feels in this game like maybe they're facing a Canadian defense. 12 guys on the field. It feels like there's an extra on every snap because they have really struggled to make headway through the air.
On first down, they'll start out with Singletary. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves them with 2 to go on second down. Well, they'll take that every time with a lead. First down, fourth quarter, getting 8 yards. You love that.
They will take it, and you have to ask the defensive guys, why did you give it? I mean, you know the situation. You're down, have to stop them, have to get the football back. But 8 yards on first down puts them back on their heels.
They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, losing yardage back at the 9-yard line. It's a loss of 4. Now third down. Throwing is Allen on third. And this heads straight to the sideline. I don't think they're going to let him get away with that. Nope, they won't. Here comes the flag. Now, if you're going to get rid of it, you better get outside the pocket.
Yeah, you have to get outside of that tackle-to-tackle box, right? Get out there, and then you can do it legally. But he wasn't able to do so, and they end up losing the down as well.
And he's able to get it out of there, and this is a pretty good kick.